Thank you for tuning in with Enchantress. That's me, the babbler. That's me on this evolutionary, revolutionary ride. Seven uprise at this time. I am.
And that's not nice.
Her whole entire schmoo change with collars, right? Some people don't want to be collared. Either way, I am just setting up and stuff like that now so that I can do a video with you because my Edgar Allan Poe tarot is calling out to me, and I guess there's some messages that want to be revealed, you know what I mean? So give me a couple of minutes because I will be right back. Okay.
And praises be to the almighty machine. Beam me up, chew me up, eat me up, swallow me up. Assimilate me. Condense me. Digitize me. Hypnotize me. With all your necessary big thing. Can't live without
Moldavite.
Allowing
Time later, I need to get back into the element. I was in the zone. I hope each of you are wonderfully okay, even though there's an audacity of an energy intermingling out there wanting to engage and play and keep you in the same cycle, because they refuse to grow out of a cycle. So we take these things and we align with our truth, because our truth is our power, that is our knowledge, that is our base, that is our system, that is our empowerment. Good. I love this. Let's work our sacrals. This is the creative time, right? Always a creative time. I don't understand boredom. I never get bored. Going live on Sundays. I will be only sharing the free link. It's gonna be free. The link to those that actually sign up for it. So other than that, it'll be undisclosed. It's like a private party for those that actually inquire and want to be down. And it's just every Sunday it's gonna be a different theme, different energy of spirit to get you in your further aligned. Mind, body, heart, and soul, just engaging with you in the way that I do, so bold, and just channeling into you and getting you to participate with me. Every single week, I'll tell you what it is that you need to bring, if you want to bring anything, but definitely pen and paper, and a good motherfucking attitude. We'll stretch, we'll talk, see some cards. Okay, so Edgar Allan Poe. I've been reading Edgar Allan Poe since before the age of 10 years old. I have to always associate the Empress. Here we go, 10 of Cups, and your cups of love here, right? It's kind of like the Empress here. It's like me and my daughter. It's like you there, come bring to me what? Right? Look, but I see a rainbow. Alright, so what are you working on? What are you cultivating? Oh, look at the music, man. Alright, so look at, there's a music. So, this Empress and Divine Feminine. Divine Feminine. Hey, so here in doom and gloom, right? It's just like, it is what it is, right? It's like, you come to me, right? Because I'm the Empress, right? Divine being with a daughter, right? I have a child. or be with child. They already have a child, because, like, this child is already here. Right? Born. Bam. Spitting image of you. Right? And look it, right? So there's been some heartbreak, too. So there's some kind of heartbreak this Empress here is going through. Right? Some kind of... Or just... And this doesn't even have... What is happening? Okay. Heartbreak. Because of this person that drowned themselves. The self-sabotage. So somebody self-sabotaged. And since I'm looking at a dude right here, some dude self-sabotaged something. And all of those people that he thought were for he are actually watching him sink over the heartbreak he brought to this Empress. Right? But she's been working on some stuff. And there's some kind of music man coming. Right? But, like, when I say it like that, hold up, because this, I'm looking at this funny. It's like she don't even see. But you see how she's content and cultivating and in her garden, her own garden? But look at the skulls. But there's been a death cycle. Two. One, two. Third one is the charm. You know? It's like after some time. Right? Having the Ten of Cups, right? But I like Edgar Allan Poe, right? So we're going to read from here too, right? Because I like this. But we're going to talk about this masculine energy here that self-sabotaged himself, because he did that against an Empress energy. So, like, whatever could have been is sinking. It's sinking. Oh, wow. It's sinking. So something could be sinking, like a relationship, right? Heartbreak or some kind of something, right? Here we go. Right, we got the Empress here. I like to share the different variations of tarot. You know, I'm always going to intuitively express, but especially when I have, like, interesting dialogue and different interpretations of tarot oracles, it's fascinating, right, to incorporate different. This is why I love art, right? Art is something that I absolutely can appreciate, because it has so many different multi-dimensional layers of existence that create in itself a color of expression that is unique in itself. Anyways, look at me started. Oh, something about reading. People keep asking me to read to them. Because they like my voice. So, believe it or not, I'm even considering it, because I'm just like, you know what? All the kids listen to me. They like when I read, because I read colorfully. And my daughter too used to enjoy it when I used to read. She's saying she wanted me to do it. But, you know, that was also thing. She wanted to do it, but she loves to read herself, so she wanted me to do it. But, you know what I'm saying? And then, like, it's just funny, you know, all the different things that come up as they come up, because you just being yourself, right? And it's just like, why? You want me to read to you? What kind of book do you want? So let me know. So it's gonna be fun. Like, everything is just all about expansiveness, colorfulness, and expression, right? And just being able to do this kind of thing, right? And finding different, like, outlets and creative tools for you to express your magic too, because you are magical. You are a magical being. Power affirmation, confirmation, power affirmation, activation. Oh, I know right now. Say, I am powerful. I am beautiful. I am creative. I am super creative. I am super duper creative. I am super duper 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 dupest creative. Right? See how when I let my tears go and let them flow, even when some of them are not mine, because I'm trapped with iron and courage for a whole society? Do you know what I mean? And it's just like, okay, on top of my own kind of things. And it's just like, oh, come on, dagger, please. you can get the best of me, you can break a button, break a ball. Do you know what I'm saying? Right? So here we are. We have the Empress. In the story, Morella. Morella nurtures the narrator with her intelligence. Her brain is her bounty. The narrator says Morella's erudition. We're going to learn words together. Erudition. Erudition was profound. We're moving on. Her powers of mind were gigantic. Morella suffers an illness but becomes pregnant. Put a cap on it. Ultimately, she dies during childbirth. During labor, Morella says she's dying, and when my spirit departs, shall the child live. Over time, the narrator watches his daughter grow. He says, for that, her smile was like her mother's, I could bear. But then I shuddered at its too perfect identity. Morella is reborn as her daughter. The narrator acknowledges this when, at his daughter's baptism, he names her Morella, and the girl dies instantly. When he bore her to the tomb, he found no traces of the first Morella. In the image, Morella stands with her daughter. The symbol of Venus suggests fertility and creativity. The cypress is an enduring tree and can be associated with reincarnation. The triple goddess symbol represents maiden, mother, and crone, the three phases of a woman's life. Pluto hangs in the sky and symbolizes mystery. I keep talking about damn Pluto hitting, right? So hitting, I'm telling you, like, listen, I just listen, okay? And I just know what I know. I've been saying that too since before the internet. They've been like, how do you know that? I just know what I know and I don't know. I just know what I know and that's it. I don't know how I know what I know, but that's it. I have so many different variations of saying it like that, right? But, whatever, right? But Pluto, hidden. There's, like, mysteries deep that even those that think that they can see and they think they have answers, they think they're way ahead of others because they think they have more information or they get it first. Ejaculation time, because you're about to get ejaculated all over your face by the universe saying, get back into your space of a place. Do you understand? Right? You are no better than nobody else. Okay. Don't get me started. Right, so anyways, so right. So there's things coming into light, shining bright, right? And it's just like what I was waiting for. Reincarnation, right? So think of reincarnation while you're still alive, like the death cycle, right? So I always say I die a million one deaths a night because with the blood, right? So it's just like, right. Bueno, okay, we're gonna be okay, right? So what do we do? We need to follow Santo up in this bitch, right? So it's kind of like that movie with Denzel Washington that I'm always referencing, right? The Fallen or some shit like that, where a spirit travels through like this one. Like troublesome spirit that doesn't want to leave Denzel Washington alone keeps body jumping. Right, so it's like if your vessel doesn't do it, it's like saying that saying, it's like what you won't do, somebody else will. What you won't do, somebody else will, right? So don't miss the boat. Because he's self-sabotaging himself. He said, wait, let me tie myself to an anchor. Right? The fool, not the partner. Right, so the Empress means abundance in all areas of your life, okay? So this divine feminine energy has abundance in all areas of her life, right? You're full. Remember, he, she, me, thee. It's my conditioning of how I speak, you know what I mean? These are all energies. It's not gender specific, so take it however it resonates for you, okay? Thank you. You're full of grace, love, and good energy.
energy.
You might also welcome a new child, as this card represents pregnancy. But I can't find anything that into any of that kind of stuff. Because I know there's a few places that I want to go before I go there in another. Even though if I do, it's going to be a new business. But either way. Right. What are we going to say? So, if you need a break from your hectic schedule, tap into your five senses. Get a massage. Didn't I tell you guys that I went to the spa? That was much needed for the new moon. I went to the new moon and I had a spa day with my daughter. Yay. And it was like a hip hip hooray. I went into... Oh, I have to talk about that. I'm actually going to give a little review because that's the second time that I went to that spa too. And I absolutely love it because they do Asian body work, which is the kind of practice that I do. Even though I infuse Western and Eastern. But most of the modalities of stretch and body work that I facilitate on and do to the people that I work on, it's Asian body work. Okay? Because if you want like a common... like Swedish massage and all that deep tissue massage, go to a motherfucking spa, because that's not me, because your clothes are still on even when I'm working on you. So anyways, either way, yeah, I don't do that kind of massages. No. Right? So yeah, so I went to the spa, and I had went to the spa right before COVID hit and loved it. I was like, oh my god, I'm gonna go every week. And then COVID hit, right? So I hadn't gone since. And so I went, and this time I took my daughter. And what I love about this place is it's like a day spa, and it has different saunas and different settings and stuff like that. So like different rooms with different kind of like salt crystals or crystals or clay, and like it's just a whole bunch of different kind of like saunas, okay? And then it has the ancient baths, right? So they have different bodies of water with different temperatures and then different mixtures. So like, you know, this herbal tea bath, this salt thing, this hot, this cold, or, you know, like whatever. And then they have Asian body work, which is ashiatsu. Ashiatsu is kind of like, it's very similar to a lot of stuff that I do. Like, I don't have a name for like what I do. I just do my own signature blend based on what you need, and I incorporate both Western and Eastern philosophy and modalities, and I just infuse based on what you need for you, and that's just how it is that I do. And you know, if I had to label it, that's how I would label that kind of system. And it's like a mix. But either way, that's my shit. So you can't find that around. Like, trust me, I think there's one like in New York City, but like in the New Jersey area. Like, so this one I had to go drive all the way to Edison. And amazing. When she told me we were there, I was like, no. She's like laughing. I'm like, I'm serious. Can I take you home? It's like, come here. I love you so much. So it was amazing. I had such an amazing experience. I forgot the name, Island Spa, something like that. But it's in Edison. It's the only one, and they do Asian body work there. And they're even more pricier than me. I was like, okay. But we're gonna go. Okay. So that's how we're gonna be. So look at that. And I traveled to you. But I have actually, for body work, I am closed out. I have the clients that I have for body work, and that is it. Because I do too much other stuff, you know, with all the stuff that I do, because I teach as well, and I do all my readings, and I do all kind of coaching, and I do a lot of behind the scenes. I blog, I do YouTube, and I'm a mother, and like, you know, just a lot of stuff. So like, it is what it is. And so, and then I am like, stuff that I want to do, and then I'm like in the middle of like, whoop, and just a lot of stuff is going on too, like a lot of stuff. Yeah, so upright creativity, abundance, motherhood, beauty, fertility, growth, rebirth, romance cycle. So there's a romance cycle for this Empress, right, that is being rebirthed, reincarnated, right? So maybe something didn't work out in the past with someone that has self-sabotaged, like the relationship, or ruined the relationship, or just they drowned, right, they went on the water, like it was just like, bam, we dead, or we got the swords and everything, slay. Right, but meanwhile, the Empress has been cultivating, right? But there's some kind of music man, because yeah, I say music man because look at what he got, this huge ass instrument, and then look at the rainbow, he's like coming, rushing, and maybe it's like a faded kind of event, like of some sort, right? Putting to death what has needs to die already, right? And then see, so this Ten of Wands, we're gonna go to that masculine, right? Ten of Wands, like, let's see what he did. Cause I don't understand, like, why you gotta be all Ten of Wands and so sabotagey and all this kind of stuff when you know you was happy at one point, but it's like you let your own fears get the best of you. And look at the plague, so it's like you were led the wrong way. It's like these were supposed to be your people, right? You wanted to be like your people, and look at, they fucking threw you out on the fucking out of the boat. Oh, these are my people. Splash. We don't like you. Oh no, I said that. Right? Telltale heart. In the oblong box, Cornelius Wyatt jumps from a sinking ship with his wife's coffin tied to his back. Killed her. He killed her. So look at the responsibility of the weight. Like, so maybe this dude, right? So maybe some kind of dude self-sabotage too. Because I tell you this, I'm going to read this intuitively. I'm going to just say however it is that I'm receiving, right? So this dude maybe had somebody that could have been, would have been, or was like his wife, partner, life partner, whatever. And he did something that killed that whole motherfucker. And look at now, he carries the weight of that on him. Right, so why? So despite his determination to live, Wyatt drowns because the ship's captain wouldn't let him take the coffin onto the lifeboat. Having promised his wife that he would deliver her body to her mother, Wyatt chooses death rather than abandon her corpse. And, you know, if there's anybody too that is manipulative or you feel that might, you know, go into a deep depression, like if you need them or they're going to be so brokenhearted in some kind of way that they would rather not live, or, you know, I don't like to go down these routes of, like, scenarios and stuff like that, or just, you know, like, whatever. Just please do seek help, and then also to be vocal about that. Like, don't sit back. If you think somebody is capable of doing something like that, don't sit back and say nothing. Like, maybe you can't be the one to help them. Granted, it's not your responsibility, but that doesn't mean that your level of accountability and intuition that can pick up on something like that should allow for something like that, and at least tell people that can help. Like, let's say, you know, this person has parents, or this person has a brother or a sister, or, you know, somebody that, you know, and granted, you tell them and they do nothing, right? At least you told somebody. Like, don't not tell somebody out of privacy, or, like, you know, if you pick up something on in your intuition, I don't know, this may be for just one person. Like, if you really feel somebody, like, is capable of, like, taking their own life because they fucked up shit with you, you know, then clearly, you know, that person does need the love, healing, and attention, and help that is way over your head. So don't, if you know something, say something. You know? I don't like the sense. In another instant, both body and box were in the sea, disappearing suddenly at once and forever. In this image, lifeboat passengers watch Wyatt disappear beneath the waves. The sea is choppy and difficult to navigate. The sky is dark with clouds. Both symbolize intense life challenges. Lifeboat passengers hold 10 candles that will light their way as they head toward land. The red hue of the sky and Wyatt's shirt symbolize the courage to move forward in a different, to move forward in a different way than what you really thought it was going to be like before you were dropped. Right? Like, he, like, broke his own heart. That's what I hear. He broke his own heart. The red hue of the sky and the white shirt symbolize the courage to move forward in difficulty and the energy to carry heavy burdens. So, somebody's going to be carrying such a heavy burden on this side, right? And then you have the Ten of Cups, right? We're not gonna read the Three of Swords because we don't need to. Right? Then you have the Ten of Cups. Right? And the Devil. Capricornian energy, right? Devil card. But, you know, it doesn't have to be. A devil card for me, too, like, when I think about the devil card, it's not a devil card, it's the Ten of Cups. I'm just saying, like, the devil card. I look at it like fixed, right, in nature, something that's so fixed. So it could be the fixed signs too, right? The signs that is hard to change, hard to break, hard to transform, like, you know, and just the idea of that kind of stuff. So it doesn't necessarily have to be like Capricornian energy, right, I like to say. But, you know, people say it, but, you know, fixed, or a lot of fixed elements in your chart and stuff like that, right? Or just conditioning, some kind of whatever, but anyway. In The Devil in the Belfry, Poe takes us to a small, isolated town called Vanderbottemittis. Said out loud, the name sounds like wonder what time it is. This is one of Poe's satirical work. And it pokes fun at people who are overly concerned with tradition and orderly systems at the expense of fluidity and creativity. So, right? So somebody too overly concerned with image and trying to make do with tradition, that they ignore their passions, their heart, their calling to try to adhere to a imaginary calling of tradition and conditioning and bullshit. Right? In this image, green hills and cabbage gardens represent abundance, and rainbow arcs in the distance symbolizing peace. 10 chalices stand in the cabbage fields, symbolizing growth and bounty. The town has 60 little houses, one for each second in a minute and minute in an hour. The town dwellers tend their cabbage and make sure that the clock tower, which has 7 faces, one on each of the 7 sides of the steeple, right, so that it can be readily seen from all quarters. Controlling! What? So like something that somebody is so controlling in terms of their love or the image of love is what I'm hearing, like screaming. Like, so it's just like image. It's just like, you know, me being prideful. I can only give for an example from me, right? Being so prideful, right? In terms of just image of like, I will not, you know, play. We're not gonna use me as an example right now. Not on the right side of my mouth. I choked. A devil carrying a fiddle. You know what I even hear right now? A devil carrying a fiddle. A devil carrying a fiddle came here to the middle and said, here, I have this fiddle for you. I can give you everything you want, plus more. But all you have to do is give me some of you. Give me some of you. Give me some of you, I want you. Here's this little fiddle for you, but I give you everything. I give you everything that you ever want and need. And then the fiddler said, oh, yes, really? For me? Yes, for you, because you are so deserving, you are so handsome, and you're so this, and you're so that. And I, la, 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 la. And that person said, oh, I knew I was waiting, I knew I was deserving, I knew you was deserving me for me, and so they took the fiddle, went around them, in the middle. A devil carrying a fiddle nearly 5 times as big as himself enters the town and chaos ensues. The devil enters the clock tower, attacks the belfry, and rings the bell 13 times. Skulls atop 2 chalices indicate trouble and remind us not to let comfort make us complacent. Wow. So even now, look, I'm looking at this dude here in the book version, right? Because it's a larger depiction of it, right? You can see his face, right? So it's like someone that comes in to disrupt your life, right? So this could be, this even tells me with devil energy, like when you think about it, the spiritual warfare and stuff like that, people doing stuff in the dark behind the scenes to fuck your shit up. You know what I mean? Like really making an effort, thinking about you. burning candles to you. I'm not even giving you ideas of what you can possibly motherfucking do. What do you pay somebody to do? Right? And it's just like to disrupt, but look at, listen. That's God's promise over there, that right? Everything is right, so, right, in the case of trouble, everything is right in your world. You look around at the life you've created and are in awe. You're most likely enjoying your rewarding career and family life. You feel safe and secure at home. So, like, going back to the story with the Empress, right? So, some dude did this himself, killed off whatever it was that he had going on with this Empress energy, right? But she here is moved on, right? And she here has her Ten of Cups, right? Her self-love, right? So it's like your self-love, the success you've earned during the season of the Nine Cups, right? Being successfully, like, happy and satisfied with you, mind, body, heart, and soul, with you, wish fulfilled, blessings, pleasure, abundance, indulgence, bling. Like, you know, it brings success. Like, and that came with fucking dying a motherfucking few deaths, right? Having gone through the battlefield of a lot of things, right? So it's just like everything is coming to fruition for this Empress. Beautiful, right? Look at Nine of Pentacles, right? Because she is single, sexy, confident, successful, and look at her ship is coming. Wow, her ship is, look at, because she's working on it. So there's something coming for this Empress, this Divine Feminine energy here, right? Divine Feminine energy, you can look at it, even if you're a male watching this and stuff like that, the Divine Feminine energy in you, if you are a male watching this, right? This is like saying, you have been doing the inner work, right? And it's going to start showing forth in your material plane. Have faith, all right? Because you're here, because your ships are coming in, so this could be applied in both kind of ways, right? So your ship is coming in because you've been doing the Divine Feminine energy work as well. So whether you're male or female and you're watching this, because now I have male viewers, not that I know of, but, you know, I've always had, but, like, you know, now they're communicating. So you see, because you've been doing the Divine Feminine energy work, that you feel more confident and more able to communicate freely and openly, because your ships are here, right? Because you're tapping in, because you're getting into that Divine Feminine energy of a win, like slay, right? So, ooh, child, the Lovers, right? So there's just something haunting and faded here, right? Something haunted and faded here. Tell me about these Lovers. Okay, that's our King of Swords, but we're not going to take him out because they're kind of issues with the King of Swords. I just did it, I'm a mess, you know what? Alright, we're just kidding, but listen, whatever it's gonna be, it's gonna be, right? Right, so there's just some kind of energy, what's happening with this Lover situation, right? Ace of Cups, new love, new beginning, new potential to something, right? So we're gonna read the Lovers as well from here, right? So you get the Lovers with new love that's gonna be worked on, it's gonna be worked on, right? Right, for this Empress Divine Feminine energy. So if you've been doing the inner work, then there's something coming in for you in regards to love, to a choice being made, right, in the dark. So it has this kind of, like, not just in the dark, but, you know, out of the darkness emerges light, right? So you know how, like, you know, people do stuff in the dark too, right? But whatever is in the dark shall be brought into light, right? So it's kind of like that. So it's like, if the, it's like making a decision on love, and now it's allowed to come in, and together at the same time. It's like alignment, it's divine right timing, right? This love, right? I love that. That's nice. Right? So we got the Lovers here. The poem, Annabelle Lee, was written for a woman who was most likely Poe's soulmate. Consider the poem's fifth stanza. And neither the angels in heaven above, nor the demons down under the sea, can ever dissever my soul from the soul of the beautiful Annabelle Lee. True love indeed. This image features Edgar Allan Poe. And so maybe there's like a, no, we're not going forward. That's it. Edgar Allan Poe and, okay. Yes, listen. Stop. soulmate. That you don't have, or that you didn't get to have. And there's like some kind of resurrection to that. But reincarnated. So like a past life love, reincarnated, or maybe like a past lover, like the most recent past lover that was so like heart-wrenching, ripped your heart out, soul out, because I mean that person was you, but like that soul just is from theory, like fallen, like another higher level soulmate flame is then sparked in someone that is there in alignment to be that for you, which now severs the soul tie in this earthly realm. And you know everything about it, that makes sense. I'm gonna watch this back at some point myself. I'm gonna... Alright, so in the Rider-Waite Smith card, the angel Raphael flies above a man and a woman, blessing them and signifying their connection to the universe. The Raider soars above the couple, representing the psychic connection between soulmates. So there's some kind of psychic connection between this soulmate and you, this new, but we're going with new, right? New love, new potential, new cup, right? That's coming in because you've been working on that. See, like, if you weren't working on it, then I would say, hey, you need to work on it so that your chip can come in. So if that's you, you're like, I don't know what the hell you're talking about. But then the sister is saying, hey, because I'm going to talk in the alignment that comes with me. That means you working on a lot of these things. You see what I mean? Because that, I'm going to expect this for you, so I'm going to go positive with that, too. So that's how I'm going to speak, because that's the alignment and alchemy of me, to speak in that kind of degree of solutions, right? So understand. So if you are here and you are not in that solution, basically like, I'm not actually working on any of this. I wish my freaking ship was coming in, wanting to hear the message as it is, right? For you to say, hey, I need to do what I need to motherfucking do in the divine feminine energy realm, which is that of your yin energy, your emotion, so that it can act in its yang energy external, right? Because that's how the divine feminine and divine masculine energies work within you, right? When you're coexisting harmoniously, right? You're activating the highest potential of each energy, feminine, masculine. Each one has a role specific to its category of energy and element, right? So because it has this, then you are able to then further extract and infuse your space, your consciousness, your mindfulness, to then apply the dynamics of it together. So in me understanding my feelings, I'm able to now find the solution to how I can activate that on my external life. So like, let's say I'm feeling sad and I don't want to be depressed, right? Then I'm going to go paint. And that helps me feel, I'm going to go dance because that helps me feel better. So I'm taking the feeling and I'm now finding a solution to that feeling through my actions. You get what I'm saying? Right? So it's like that, right? So you're finding that, whether it be in an actual physical relationship that's coming in, right? Or within yourself. Because you know how I like to do a lot of things about myself. I'm a very independent, my feminine goddess here, activated both yin and yang inside my own damn alchemized element, right? And I have to coexist harmoniously with both energies existing with me, which is the Holy Trinity alchemy within me. You know what I mean? And it doesn't mean that I'm exempt from other things. Either way, right? So the full moon signifies a love so complete that even the angels grew envious. As Poe says, the angels not half so happy in heaven when envying her and me. So like, this could be also like a relationship that people around you, like it could be gossip, it could be just the energies around you and a certain someone working against you, right? So that could be like witchcraft, spell work, and all that kind of stuff too. Like, you know, like somebody behind the scenes doing a lot of shit more than me. So there was something, and maybe that's happening now, like the closing out of a cycle, right? This full moon that's coming into, because it came from the new moon, right? Hopefully a closing out of all the fuck shit energies behind the scenes that are doing a lot of things energetically manipulating from these two from being together, you see, causing like kind of blind to truth, like making them think that the problem is between them two, but it's really not. It's a ruse. A ruse. A full moon suggests the completion of a cycle or the culmination of energy to be released. Here it represents the apogee of Poe's love for Annabelle Lee, the finality of her death, and the release of her soul to the universe. For the moon never beams without bringing my dreams of the beautiful Annabelle Lee into the maelstrom. The lovers may denote a soulmate connection or point to a close relationship with a sibling, friend, or co-worker. Search your soul to find out who you are and what you value. You'll be faced with choices that call on your morals and ethics. This card is about authenticity and being true to who you are no matter how difficult the situation. So, right? It's like being true to yourself. It's just like, it's like Romeo saying, Romeo and Juliet, right? Juliet, like, she stood up for Romeo, right, against her family and saying, no, I want to marry this one, you know, like, whatever. But it was like Juliet shunning Romeo because she was sticking by her family. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's like not being true to yourself, not being authentic and true to you because you're trying to live up to your commitment too. So it's just like, you know the truth and you know what you really want, but you're saying something else and doing something else completely different because you're following a suit into what you think you need to be doing or whatever the case. I don't know. But yeah. So, right. So, I hope these messages resonate and you like them. So how it operates a lot for me is that I could be sleeping or I could be like whatever. Certain decks always pull out to me. I always have decks I bought. I walk around with the same decks. I have over 100 oracles and tarots. I collect these things. I make these things. And like for today, Edgar Allan Poe, this deck has been calling me for the last 2 days. So I've been carrying this deck with me for the last 2 or 3 days. Sorry, I have no concept of time. And I know that it was to do this, right? But I didn't know when. I just know that I aligned with divine right time, right? So, but in the meantime, I felt the, and I, you know, as if you're a tarot reader and you watch this and stuff like that, you know what I mean? Like sometimes certain decks call out to you and they speak to you, right? Like they speak to you even before they speak, right? So for the last 2 or 3 days that I've been carrying the deck with me, I've just been bonding with it. Like, you know, it's just a bonding. Like, I'm weird. I'm a very weird person. I used to bond with crayons. I said, if you watched any of my other videos, and I used to say that, you know, crayons had life for me and they each had a role and they had a relationship and red and blue always wanted to date, but pink was always interrupting. So, and then people used to argue with me and tell me that red and blue were both masculine energy, and I'm like, red is a girl! So give me some. Okay. The lovers may denote a soulmate connection or point to a close relationship with a sibling, friend, or co-worker. Search your soul to find out who you are and what you value. You'll be faced with choices that call on your morals and ethics. This card is about authenticity and being true to who you are no matter how difficult the situation. So be true to you no matter how difficult the situation is. Okay? And if you need time for yourself to just establish that for yourself and give yourself that time, you owe nobody any motherfucking explanation for taking the time that you need for yourself to decide what is best for you. Okay? It's about love, trust, marriage, soulmates, balance, commitment, choices, contracts, business, partnerships, right? So the lovers, right? Then, three of pentacles. Let's go down. Let's get into our pentacles. Okay. In the story, A Tale of Jerusalem, three pious. Jewish men sit on a building ledge near the city of Pompeii, okay? Together they toil in the temple and exhibit teamwork. The men send money down in a basket to two men below as a temple sacrifice. In this image, three scarab beetles representing the Three of Pentacles. The two men who receive the money are Romans. The Romans steal the money and send the basket back up with a large hog, an unclean animal in Mosaic law. The three Jewish men saw nothing of the Romans' trickery as if it was concealed by heavy fog that surrounded the city below. Poe intended this to start looking at, this could be coming after, even just, that sly, foxy kind of betrayal, somebody did something underneath your nose, you know what I'm saying, and thought that they were going to get away with it. But you already know, we all be wearing more for yourself, and if you intentionally deceive, it's like, when you know better, you do better, but if you know better, and you still don't know better, that's nothing different! That's just as different! That's a different level of stupidity. Like, not even I would be that stupid. you trust me. Right? When you try to play spirit, and you try to play the divine, because you think you're going to go outsmart what is ancient. This vessel of yours is temporary. Your soul is infinite. Right? That means you are forever. But in this vessel, there's a lot of information and things hidden from you, right? Pluto holds all that information, but let's talk about that later. I have Pluto Akashic, but it's in the ethers. Okay, we'll talk about that later too. Okay, either way, what was I saying? Ooh, that was the wipeout, right? It was like the Men in Black. Okay, come and then shut up. Whatever. Okay, it doesn't matter. Okay, when you are crooked, thinking you could crick it, you mistake. Okay. Poe intended the story as a humorous parable, but like so many stories in the 19th century, it comes across as a racist as well as contains historical inaccuracies. It's imperative that you collaborate with others. Others need your expertise and you need theirs, okay? So you need to keep doing whatever it is that you need to do, which is what you are doing, right? You are now applying, even if there's a lot of fuck shit energies going on, even if there's a lot of things going down, right, that are happening inside. Look at that. I shared with you guys all the day of just my emotions in that kind of way, but I'm a transmuter, I'm a transformer. I don't sit around and pretend everything's motherfucking okay, but it's not. But I don't sit there and let that shit mess up my alchemy either. All right, balance, right? But that doesn't mean that I ignore how I feel, and it doesn't mean I don't allow the feeling to be, right? Because we gotta transmute, you see, and that means you gotta feel in order to deal so that you can heal, okay? You need to feel in order to deal so that you can heal. FDH. You need to feel. In order to deal so that you can heal. Okay? Feel, deal, heal. You heard? Alright. Right? So, it's imperative that you collaborate with others. Others need your expertise and you need theirs. You simply cannot get the job done without teamwork. Teamwork makes dream work. Woo! Okay. I'm loving each and every one of you that I'm connecting with you guys in the corner. I'm loving the growth of my channel, whether it be here on Instagram, on my blog, on my website, or if I'm coaching you, or, you know, whatever the case may be, we're just connecting, or you're part of my 2021 Enchanting Love giveaways, so make sure to follow me on all my social media platforms, because I give away shit! I collaborate with beautiful souls all across, around this motherfucking globe, this multi-dimensional universe, and we give away cool motherfucking things. Okay! For free! Okay? Yeah. So. You know why? I'm not gonna touch it because we're gonna buy something. But you wanna know why? Because I know what it feels like to have nothing. Okay? And I've always been a gift giver. I give the best gifts. I love you. Oh, you get gifts from me. You get love. And nobody should ever feel not lucky, not good, or like they can get something. That's all. And because I dealt with last year catty ass bitches, right, that I was part of giveaways with and stuff like that, and there's such hateful little freaking energies behind their scenes. They pretend, 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 but hateful they are. And I was like, fudge this shit, I don't need you! I can do this shit myself and be real! So that's where this came about. That is why I started the 2021 Intending Life giveaways. Because I dealt with catty ass bitches. right? You even try to play me behind the scenes. That's okay. Right? It is what it is. Unappreciative, ungrateful, and whatever. It is what it is. I'm not here to judge. I just don't got time for you. All cut off. And so I love the soul tribe that I do connect and vibe with, because y'all some generous, loving, wise, kind, blunt. The way can smoke ya. And that's the kind of real I love. That. The kind that, listen, it's not that I'm hurting you. I'm not trying to hurt you. I'm not trying to insult you. I'm not trying to, like, whatever. It just is what it is, right? If we can actively, harmoniously, healthily communicate in such a respectful kind of way where you can articulate and opinionate however it is that you want to be and breed and see, there's no hateful energy coming from me, for we're both here to succeed. I'm here to help you achieve your dream just as much as I want to achieve my own. And it feels much more good when you can energize in that kind of zone, you know? I make things, right? I made this feather wand. I've shared it before, right? If it gets less and less, it's because Andromeda, my cat, likes to eat weird things, like all my feathers and whatever. She loves the crystals, but Andromeda be eating shit. Like, it's chewed. Where is it? Look at this part of this chewed. Well, one of the pieces is missing. This was long. This used to be love. But anyways, so this is a crystal feather wand, right, that I made. Yay. So the feathers I get from all these, my spirit animal friends on the outside, because I do feed them, I do interact with ravens, crows, why am I forgetting all their names? Blue jays and woodpeckers and just a bunch of my house squirrels, chipmunks, all that kind of stuff. And they leave me presents. They really do. Whenever they hear me, they all go, oh, speaking of crows. Crows are cocking. What are they talking about today? So, there's, gossip. One. Okay. Two, news on its way. Something that's going to be made loud. That's what I heard, because they were a little bit loud today. And I was like, all right. I get it. Loud. So people could be quacking loud. We'll talk about that, like, whatever, but I have to go. Alright, so, loud. Like, really loud. Like, the audacity kind of loud. Like, they used to call me Mike Tyson in high school. Loud. And Xena, warrior princess. Those are my two nicknames. Dina. And Mike Tyson. I would have preferred Bruce Lee. Ninja. Also ninja. Alright. So, fairy ninja. I'm a fairy ninja because I flutter. I flutter and then I flat. Mm-hmm. You didn't even see me coming. It's like, what? Yeah. Pull up. Cardi B's pull up. Pull up, pull up, pull up. I'm like, whoa, where you just came from? Yeah, I fly. Witches fly, bitch. We fly. We've learned. Oh man. Right, so. Introverts can work in ways that suits productivity and creativity. Communicate your needs. Okay, this card contains the power of the three. Therefore, your project, relationship, or lifestyle transformation is still in the initial stages. You must work, continue to work on what your crafts and all the things that you're doing at this time. This will ensure a smooth execution. You may run into a few hiccups along the way. Reassess, regroup, and move forward. You're on the right track, all right? If you were looking for confirmation about what track and what path you were on and during this crossroad time, maybe it's like crossroads time because I was seeing like crossroads. Now I'm seeing crossroads, like crossroads, like you have things like see three crossroads, right? Like three different choices, whatever, how many, right? And so it's like three different paths, like which way to go, George? Which way do I go, right? Mm-hmm. You walk your straight, authentic self path. Whichever one that is. So, teamwork, understanding, collaboration, organization, trust, and communication. Then we have the Ace of Cups, right? So we have the Ace of Cups here. Ace of Cups. I'm gonna go back to the spa because after the spa, I hit some emotional waters that I need to purge again. So, you know, I took my dogs to the doggy spa today, so they got theirs. My cat's got new collars, and Andromeda was pissed. She's like, so we took off the collar. She went, I don't think she took off the collar. Oh yeah, but this makes things lighter, this other one, okay? So, Ace of Cups. Okay, here we are, and then maybe I'll pull one more, and then we go. Thank you so much for tuning in. I appreciate each and every one of you. Like I was saying, I am loving each and every one of you that are tuning in, tapping in, and showing some love and kindness and support. And, you know, like I said, you know, let us communicate some more, because the more that we communicate, the more that this becomes even more so for you. Edgar Allan Poe is regarded as the quintessential dark and brooding romantic. Maybe that's why. Maybe I'm Edgar Allan Poe. I had stopped sharing my poetry because we were like critiquing the content, not the material, not the poem itself. They're like, this is a beautiful poem, but oh my god, like, you know, because I write dark, you know, like dark poetry, like it's my outlet, like, you know, it doesn't mean. And then also, you know, I'm an empath, so I was writing poems of things that had nothing to do with me. I used to think about that when I was little. I was writing all this love sick fucking poetry, and I'm like, I've never even had a boyfriend. What do I know about this love making, right? What do we know about anything, right? And this perceived reality of a vessel that we have, right? When we're more than this. Let me know if you want me to read to you. If you will participate in that. Yeah, it'll be fun. Get some popcorns. Right? We can read all at the same time. Right, so I dwelt on it. So he carried out many love affairs and drew upon them when writing his poems. His most famous love poem is a paean to Annabel Lee, whom he loved with a love that was more than love. Or consider the poem Eulalie, which Poe wrote for his wife Virginia, where he writes that I dwelt alone in a world of moan, and my soul was a stagnant tide. So the fair and gentle Eulalie became my blushing bride. More salaciously, Poe also wrote a Valentine to for the married Francis Sargent Osgood. Unable to reveal, I wonder if Edgar Allan's Poe was he a fucking Aquarius? Scorpio? Well, no, because he's really honest in his poetry. I find Aquarians to be liars. The energy. I'm just talking about, like, especially if they haven't found their self-identification, don't be insulted if you're an Aquarius with an Vedic astrologer, you have an Aquarius moon, okay? So I had to meet the liar in me too, so trust. I'm not saying it insultingly in any kind of way. This is for, if you've triggered in any kind of way, it's for your growth, so take that as it is, okay? I'm just saying, like, so what kind of Edgar Allan Poe, Scorpio, deep brooding, like, fixed, right? Leo. What is Edgar Allan Poe's birthday? We're curious here. I don't even know what he looks like, so I don't... Pisces. It's a Pisces, melancholic, right? Capricorn. Right, because he sacrificed. Oh, I don't know, but let's see. Edgar Allen Poe's birthday. Do you know Edgar Allen Poe's birthday? This is the kind of shit that I'll Google. Edgar Allen Poe's birthday. January 19th, motherfucking Capricorn. With Sagittarius energies too. Yeah, the Capricorn. Capricorn is so my Venus is in Capricorn, okay? In both Vedic and freaking Western, I thought it was gonna change in one or the other, but they both the motherfucking same. Explains a lot, anyways. Alright, so how many visions of a maiden that is? No, right, so many of Paul's works feature beautiful women who die or who have died. In Sonnet to Santo, the narrator says, how many visions of a maiden that is no more upon the virgin sleeps? Or take Lenore, which Paul describes the beautiful Lenore as the queenliest dead that ever died so young. His image features a chalice set above the ocean and rimmed with ravens. The ravens are associated with intuition. The full moon rises in the background, symbolizing fullness of emotion. Okay, beautiful, right? So, you know, Capricorn brooding energy, when especially when they deny themselves simple pleasures, where else are they gonna, like, they need that creative outlet, right? So it's like, where it is that I'm gonna express what I suppress. Oh my god, expressing what you suppress. Capricorn expressing what they suppress. Do that now, because when you pass the torch over to the Aquarian astrological sign next, they at least know what their passion is and they can start afresh and new. Okay, this is really a lot of stuff I'm just throwing out there. Joy and emotional abundance. Your social life is picking up. You have a new love interest. New love interest! I wear my Easter cups on my third eye. I wear my Easter cups on my third eye. I wear my Easter cups on my third eye. I wear my Easter cups on my third eye. Let me get that. Friends. Those in committed relationships can experience a rekindling of love or renewal of vows. If spending time with family fulfills you, you'll find you'll build new memories and remnants on happy times. You might receive a wedding or pregnancy announcement. An increase in intuition is indicated here. You could create an at-home business based on your intuitive talents, such as Reiki, music, or art therapy. Okay? Love, creativity, romance, inspiration, subconscious intuition, joy, fulfillment, new beginnings, right? So, thank you so much for tuning in. I hope that you enjoyed yourself all week. Make sure subscribe and let me know how these messages resonated with you. Thank you so much. So we speak again. Look at the world card. So there's somebody coming in to look at this judgment here for somebody that's coming to your castle. Journeyed along, singing a song in search of El Dorado. El Dorado is said to be a hidden empire or city of immense riches. It's used as a metaphor for the Holy Grail, okay? An object or goal of great significance. We're reaching our goals of great significance here, right? So the knight believes the golden city of El Dorado is the key to happiness, success, and love, and it may even contain the entrance to heaven. Somebody might be living in a delusion and think that this is the way to do whatever it is they need to do, but it's a lesson that they even have to come to. Judgment is here for that, too. That's a different kind of proof. That's the hybrid proof. So if you watched the hybrid video, that is for them. They think that the path that they're taking now, they're right. Hey. Alright, so over the mountains, up the moon, down the valley of the shadow. The pilgrim's shadow indicates that spiritual treasures such as wisdom, knowledge, unity, wholeness, and enlightenment can be found through death. Oh! Only through the death and rebirth of your soul can you complete your life's journey. In this image, a knight on horseback approaches an elaborate city of gold. As represented by the settling of the full moon, his mission has ended. Vast green mountains symbolize success. A new era begins at sunrise. A new beginning, new in love. New beginning in love after death. So they're new. That's what it's going to be called. New beginning in love after death. No beginning in love after death. New beginning in love after death. New beginning in love. New beginning of love. And love after death. Edgar Allen Poe Oracle. Thank you for inspiring that, guys. Okay. That's some Palo Santo up in this bitch. A new era begins at sunrise. You have successfully completed your mission. A cycle in your life is now over. The world provides the stability to move ahead in your life's mission. Your project, relationship, studies, or career have reached completion. You may receive a diploma, get married, retire, or launch a project. Whatever the occasion, you should feel proud that you triumphed in the face of obstacles. You've reached a goal. It's time to celebrate. Take a moment to look back on all you've accomplished before setting new goals. I am excited for this completion now here in my life. I am super grateful and excited for the success that is here now. I am overjoyed for all of my achievements. I am so thrilled to be divinely led, divinely guided, divinely protected. This feeling of fulfillment fills me inside out. I am excited for the new beginnings in my life. I welcome harmony at all motherfucking times, my body, heart, and soul. I look forward to my world travel and multidimensional travel all the time. Great. Thank you. So we speak again. Make sure to read everything in the description box because that is how you and I can really connect more. And...